Watch WWE Presents. Cue the sad tunes. Or don't, I could care less. Wrestling fans are cold and callous, keeping emotions inside like kids after dark. What the fuck was that joke? Fans of the WWE usually aren't reduced to tears, but at certain times, all the elements come together, the right characters, a good storyline, an overwhelming feeling of emotion, and sometimes, overly surreal moment that you'll see the rare sight of the internet's worst creation shedding a tear. I'm D Wicket from Watch WWE, and these are the 10 WWE moments that made you cry. Number 10, Edge's retirement. I originally planned Ric Flair's retirement to be here, but let's take this into consideration. Ric Flair eventually went to TNA to wrestle multiple more times, and Flair had lost the night before in a retirement match, so if nothing else, it was expected. He came out and talked about his career, his accomplishments, and the realities of wrestling before telling us that an MRI forced him to retire. Edge went down as one of the best of all time, and his retirement, while not as much of a show as Flair's, was a damn tearjerker. Number 9, the post-9/11 national anthem. Not sure why, but Backlash this year is booked on 9/11, and it reminded me of this. Just a few days after the terrorist attack on the Twin Towers, SmackDown went live and all the Number 8, Jim Ross announces Owen Hart's death. Over the Edge 1999 will go down in history as the infamous day that Owen Hart fell to his death, and then WWE continued the pay-per-view anyways, which is sorta horrible in itself. Yet still, Jim Ross is an absolute professional, and he was tasked with the unfortunate job to explain the events that didn't air live, until Jim Ross broke the air and explained what had happened.
Responsibility to let everyone know that Owen Hart has died. Owen Hart has tragically died from that accident here tonight.
Number 7, Chris Benoit openly mourning Eddie's passing. This isn't the last time you'll see either of these men on the list. However, it's very widely well known that Chris Benoit and Eddie Guerrero were very good friends. Best friends. Eddie Guerrero passed away in 2005, and WWE had a very nice tribute for him, and one of the most notable reactions of a superstar on the ramp was Chris, who was openly weeping for the passing of his good friend Eddie. It's one of those moments where in hindsight, it makes it an even sadder moment. Knowing what we know now, Chris was already going through a lot in his life, and losing his best friend was just another crushing blow. Number 6, I'm sorry, I love you. His retirement won't be on here, but the moment that caused it will be. Shawn Michaels fought Ric Flair at WrestleMania in a retirement match, and Shawn won. The match was great, thrilling, and popping the crowd left and right, who loved both of these guys. Finally, towards the end, Flair got one final taunt in, asking for more, and Shawn, temporarily breaking kayfabe, told Ric, "I'm sorry, I love you." He then sweet chin musicked Flair. Sure, it's a verb, and immediately hugged his fallen body. Number 5, Randy Savage and Miss Elizabeth reunite. Randy Savage and Miss Elizabeth had a rocky relationship at times. Savage left Elizabeth for the sensational Sherry, but when Savage lost a retirement match at WrestleMania 7, Sherry betrayed him, kicking the now ex-wrestler while he was down and leaving him in the dust. Enter Miss Elizabeth, who was in the crowd and came out for her man, her true love. They embraced, and the match made in heaven were once again reunited. Number 4, Conor the Crusher's video. I really can't do any justice for this video, it just needs to be watched. Look it up on YouTube and embrace the fact that even a company as stupid and wacky as the WWE can make the life of a child infinitely better. Number 3, the streak ends. I'm just gonna leave this picture here. Yep, he basically sums this one up for me. Number 2, Daniel Bryan's celebration. WrestleMania 30 was a shot in the dark going into it. No one was really sure how good it would be, and people really weren't overly invested in Bryan winning because they didn't want to be let down again after all the times they had been before. However, creative prevailed correctly, and Daniel Bryan overcame all the odds to win the WWE World Heavyweight Championship in the main event of WrestleMania 30. Longtime fans, hardcore fans, and hell, even casual fans fell in love with this moment, and while his reign may have been shortened in a sad way, try and remember how huge the moment was. Almost as huge as Number 1, Eddie and Chris's celebration. If you watched Daniel Bryan's celebration at WrestleMania 30 and thought you'd seen it before, it's probably because you have at WrestleMania 20. Eddie Guerrero beat Kurt Angle to retain his WWE Championship, and Chris Benoit overcame Triple H and Shawn Michaels to win the World Heavyweight Championship, after which Eddie came out and the two celebrated together in the ring. Confetti fell down as two of the most beloved wrestlers, two best friends who deserved it all so much, sat in the ring at the ending of WrestleMania at the top of the company. was truthfully one of the most emotional moments in all of entertainment as a whole. And those are the 10 WWE moments that made us cry. What are your thoughts? Tell us in the comments below. And if you want joke making happy go lucky D Wicket to come back, sorry this is a hard video to do that with, but like the video and subscribe for more moving wrestling content. Thank you all for watching.